Hello again, Sekiro fans. This is David, Polygon Guides, and I'm going to show you how to beat the Guardian Ape and the Brown Ape. This is a retread and a bit of a twist on a previous fight, but there's good news because almost nothing you need to do changes except in the second phase when things get complicated. This is about the time where we recommend great items and moves for a boss fight, and in here, you really don't need any. Shinobi Firecrackers could help you because you can always stun your enemies and open them up for attacks, but that's nothing close to a requirement. There is, however, something we like for Brown Ape. It is the Mortal Draw combat art, which is pretty great for responding to Brown Ape's combos. Beyond that, it's really just a matter of reading attacks and responding to them with regular attacks. All right, let's talk about the first phase, which is just you and Guardian Ape. It's actually just like the second phase of your previous battle with Guardian Ape, and you generally want to avoid his attacks and capitalize on two. So, since you've already defeated Guardian Ape, you know what to look for. So we won't go into super detail on all of the attacks that he has. Let's talk about a couple of them, though. First off is his perilous attack, which causes terror. So he screams, and there's this area of effect attack. Just get away. Whenever you see it happening, run away. There's also the dive and swipe that returns when Guardian Ape dives and swipes with his sword. This is a great opportunity to attack, actually. So he does the dive and swipe. What you should do is jump over where his head should be to his shoulders, land behind his arms, and attack a couple of times at most. Run away as quickly as you can, though, because he's really, really likely to follow up with that perilous terror attack. And now here's the best move. It's the overhand smash and stun. Guardian Ape lifts his sword high above his head, holds it there, and then smashes it down to the ground. This is your best opportunity to deal damage. Whenever you see this attack coming, rejoice. Run into range and block to deflect the attack. Guardian Ape falls to the ground and he's stunned. So now you can attack several times and then, of course, run away. Phase 2 is where things get weird and different, because Brown Ape comes to the battlefield. What fun! Ugh. If you can take Guardian Ape out, Brown Ape will just sit down and give up. That said, Brown Ape is really good at flanking you and taking you out when your attention is divided, so we recommend going after Brown Ape first. And there's a good way to do that, too. Brown Ape tends to stay out of the fight unless you attack Guardian Ape, or unless Guardian Ape uses its terror-inducing perilous attack. Separate the two enemies so that you only fight them individually. Run around the arena waiting for your enemies to attack, and think defensively the whole time, attacking sporadically and only when you can follow up their attacks with your own. Focus on attacking or avoiding Guardian Ape, but don't get greedy. Take a swing or two, but keep looking for Brown Ape. When it charges, run away from Guardian Ape and fight Brown Ape alone. Let's talk about Brown Ape's attack and his combos. Brown Ape usually attacks with single swipes of its hand, and those are easy enough to block individually. You can even get in an attack or two after, but don't really concentrate on these. There's a much better way to do it. Brown Ape has a five-hit combo, which is four running swipes and then a jumping ground pound. Block and deflect everything, and feel free to count to five. That helped us. If you deflect the final attack, you'll stagger Brown Ape momentarily. Attack at that point. The Mortal Draw combat art that we talked about earlier is a really good choice here, and you can see chunks of its vitality and posture take damage. It's especially good to do this when Guardian Ape does his terror-inducing attack. That tends to be when Brown Ape does his combo, like Guardian Ape starts to scream and the red comes out and then Brown Ape charges you. So get ready for defending and then capitalizing on this combo when that happens. I straight up would not suggest fighting this fight with a ton of offense. Think defensively. You don't get any points for running and being fast and beating him in a certain time limit. Just stay away and wait for these things to happen and you will be fine. At that point in the fight, when Brown Ape is taken care of, it's just you and Guardian Ape one more time, and there's not really anything to say about Guardian Ape in the second phase of the fight that we didn't say already about the first phase. It's just you and him, and what you've already done many times before, so just avoid his attacks, keep clear of the terror, and capitalize on his dive and his overhand attacks. One other thing we should mention, though, is that the fight is not really over when it's over. You'll notice that Guardian Ape's corpse does not disappear after your second death blow. Approach the corpse and attack to kill that centipede thing and finish the fight. Defeat Guardian Ape and Brown Ape, and you will receive two prayer beads, kind of nice, and also the Memory Headless Ape. Finish the third phase, and you'll receive the Bestowal Ninjutsu. All right, that is it. Good luck, and we will see you in the next video.